grew up in church. On and off, it was more of going with neighbors or going with friends, things like that. I knew the stories about God and about Jesus, but that's what I felt like it was at that time in my life. It was just stories, and I didn't realize that, you know, our God was real and that it was, you know, more than just stories that we were told as children. I think it was around the year like 2001 or 2002. My sister had started going to a church, and she talked to me a lot about just the people at the church and the things that she was experiencing and how God was moving in her life. And she started talking to me about how she was worried about my salvation, and that the things that we thought we knew when we were younger, just being a good person, was, there was just so much more to it. I remember one night I was by myself and I was sitting in my room, and my sister wrote a letter to me, and I started praying about the letter that she wrote me, and was just asking God, you know, why I felt so empty, and why, if he was there, like, why am I so lonely, and that just this feeling that I had. And it was literally like at that moment I felt like, you know, God saying to me, I'm all you need. Like, I'm here. You just have to, you know, let me be here. And it was the most peaceful, just the most peaceful feeling. And I just felt like, I don't know, just all the loneliness and everything that I felt was just gone. And it was just a moment of, wow, you know, God is here and he loves me and he really wants me to talk to him and be, you know, have a relationship with him. We went through some really hard financial things in our life at that time, and, you know, had two newborn children basically. And we started going to a church with our friends, and just, they didn't really know how bad the struggle was that we were in at that moment in our life. They just knew that Sammy was back in school and had, like I said, God had taken him away from the job he was in, and we were just fully relying on God each day. And we literally had like $16 total in our checking account until we got paid again. And Sammy had $10 in his pocket. And they were, you know, we were praying, and they called for an offering. And Sammy was like, hey, I think I need to put that money in the offering. And I was like, are you crazy? I was like, that is like all the money we have. And Sammy's like, no, I feel led that I need to, you know, put this in the offering. And he did. And then when we walked out of the church, not only had the church like purchased all this back to school stuff for like kids, and so we had everything we needed for the back to school things for the children, but our friends who were sitting in front of us came up to Sammy and gave him $100 and was like, you know, Sammy's like, we can't take your money, you know, we don't do that. And his friend was like, no, I literally, while we were praying, I felt just God laid it on my heart that to give this to you, and you guys, you know, for you to have it. And again, he didn't know our situation, he didn't know how bad it was. And that was, you know, literally at that moment, each day we just, instead of asking God for what we needed, we just started thanking him. We felt totally at peace with, even as bad as things were, you know, financially, we were, you know, happy. And again, we just felt so at peace, just God knowing, you know, we knew that God was there with us through everything, and that we didn't have to worry about anything.